It's difficult to know where to begin in a city as densely packed with tourist attractions as Venice. An ideal method is to simply get lost for a few hours, meandering around its charming small alleyways and passageways, strolling alongside its canals and discovering its hidden gems. Venice is divided into six areas, with each of its own distinct personalities, so to help you organize your visit efficiently as possible, we'll go over some of the top attractions and activities to do in Venice. St. Mark's Basilica, unquestionably Venice's most famous church and one of the most easily recognizable in the world, was once the Doge's private chapel, filled with Byzantine art treasures carried back by Venetian ships after the fall of Constantinople. Looking down at the floor, the marble inlay masterpiece, you can tear your gaze away from the mosaic domes and a number of elaborately decorated altars. Also visit the treasury to admire the gold reliquaries and icons. The Grand Canal, which runs through the heart of Venice in a large reverse S-curve, is the city's primary thoroughfare, connecting Piazza San Marco, Rialto Bridge, and the mainland rail station with bridge arrival sites. Only four bridges span the 3.8 kilometer length through traghetti or stripped-down gondolas, shuttled down between many spots. For anyone with any sort of clout in Venice, the Grand Canal was a place to be. All of the major families' palaces face the canal, with their ostentatious Venetian, Gothic, and early Renaissance facade facing the water, which is how guests arrive. Between 1515 and 1560, the Cupola Grande del San Rocco is an outstanding white marble structure. It was built to house a philanthropic organization dedicated to San Rocco. Tintoretto, the great 16th century Venetian artist, won the competition to paint the central panel for the ceiling of the Sala dell'Albergo shortly after it was completed by entering the building and placing his painting in the intended place before judging, much to the annoyance of his rival artists. The glorification of Saint Roch, Christ before Pilate, the Issi Homo, and the most striking of all, the Crucifixion, are among the first works dating back from 1564 to 1576. Just as Cadaoro provides you a look into the life of the Middle Ages, Palazzo Rezzanico paints a vivid image of life in the 18th century throughout the Baroque and Rococo periods. The costume collection emphasizes the importance of silk production in Venice from the late Middle Ages until the 18th century, when it was completed with Lyon, France. Rigid technical regulations were implemented, resulting in some of the most stunning silk fabrics ever created. Thank you for watching. We hope this video helped you find your next location to enjoy. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel.